Okay, I wanted to update another video that I made a while ago about capos and how to use them in slightly different ways than the usual transposing thing that most singer-songwriters do. And nothing wrong with that, obviously. In the first video, which I will link down in the usual pinned comment, I had made some examples of how to use it at a basic level and how to use it in a slightly more unusual way. So I wanted to add a few things here, more on a maybe like a recording perspective and like a creating parts for songs type of ideas, so to speak. Okay, well, first of all, I have a few capos here with me. I have most of the capos that I use are the G7, like this one. I don't know if it, hopefully it will, there you go, the G7, which is possibly one of the most popular modern capos. I have a couple of those in different finishes. And then this is the Nashville, the G7 Nashville style, you know, the one with the spring. I would say these are very good. Both of these are great. My preference, if I had to play just songs and just very quickly move the capo, I would go for the Nashville one. I would say for unusual stuff, this style capo is a bit quicker to remove, because obviously you have to just give it a quick pinch in terms of the pressure. It's just much easier to find the right pressure. I find with this one, because of how it's built, it's difficult to capo just half of the guitar, half the strings, so to speak. This would be great for just a regular gig where I just, want to play chords and transpose very quickly. This, I would definitely use the Nashville style. Probably the worst capo you can get is the one with a little bit of string. Very inexpensive, but this, as much as I do want a capo, just for the fact that I've been playing guitar for a very long time, I would say that these actually throw the guitar out of pitch, so to speak, out of tune. I'm not affiliated in any way, shape, or form with G7. I just feel that they are very practical, very practical capos, and very quick to, not only very quick to move around the guitar, but they very rarely throw the guitar out of tune. Okay, so obviously the first way, the simplest way to use a capo is that to, play a chord with a different shape. You understand that a chord is the sound that comes out of the instrument. Let's say right now I'm playing D, and the shape is the visual representation of the way your fingers draw a shape on the fretboard that is recognizable visually. And let's say in this case I'm playing D with the D shape. Okay, but I could be playing by putting the cap on the second fret by the fret. I could play D with a C shape. There's obviously visually that reminds us of the C shape. I've recorded a very simple chord progression going that goes E, B, and A, something like this. Okay, something quite Coldplay-ish, so to speak. And then the first port to call would be to play those chords with different shapes. So let's say in different ranges of the guitar, I could play much higher, but the logic is the same. So I can play D, B, and A with a D shape, A shape, and G shape. Okay, so this is a guitar part that I would use against what I have in the looper. So the next example, I'm gonna put the capo only on the bottom four strings. So the B and the E are going to be open. So I'm gonna try and find chords that obviously work with the two strings open, like something in E or C sharp minor, something like this. Yeah, something like that. So I have basically the bottom strings capoed, And then the top two strings are always ringing. They're my, you know, my drone, so to speak. Okay, the next idea is to capo the top four strings. So the high E, B, G, and D. And I'm in drop D now, so the low string is a D, and obviously the A is still an A. So with this, obviously I have a lot much wider range because I can get a sound a bit, you know, like a Zeppelin-esque, a bit like with a mandolin. Okay, the next example is a bit extreme, and I would say is more for recording as a bit of a ear candy, so to speak. And I am drop D. I have a capo on the seventh fret on the bottom three strings. You can, you know, go obviously over a little bit. And then I have a capo on the 16th fret, only on the top three strings, on the E, B, and G. And you get a bit of a harmonizer style sound. It reminds me a bit of the Steve Vai stuff. Okay, and you can come up with stuff that is a bit unusual, so to speak. Obviously, with a bit of delay, this would work really well, or even like really lightly strummed. Okay, but I prefer it as an effect, like a harp, you know. And you can maybe with an acoustic guitar, if you can capo this far up on the guitar, which is very difficult, create more of an ARP style effect. Okay, I hope you enjoyed this, and as always, please like, subscribe, and share through social media. As always, there are links in the description and in the pinned comments, so please check those out. All right, take care, bye-bye.